Hello, hello, hello. This is Ash, and welcome to my latest video. Hope you're keeping well and are having a great time, or having a good week or weekend, whatever the time it is when you watch this video. Today, I'm going to be doing a little tutorial. Although, I'm probably not the best at doing tutorials, but I'm really looking forward to doing this one. And this tutorial is about installing the coach lighting bar. This one does come with some additional side LEDs for the door warning lights, which is ideal for DMUs. Also, you do get the 3-volt lithium battery, of which the code is CR2032. This does come with a kit. This lighting kit actually cost me £25, of which, judging from the reviews that I've seen of this on YouTube, I decided to invest in one of these and try it for myself. Here is the instructions printed on the back. Very simple to do. Place the battery in. And I have already removed the roof, of which is this East Midlands Trains Class 153, as I've chosen to fit the lighting unit into my only Class 153 that I currently own, as I no longer own the Central Trains version, but I do intend getting another Class 153 in either the Northern Rail or the Arriva Trains Wales livery. But I've not yet decided, but that's for another video in the future. Anyways, very much the light bar just simply sticks into the top of the roof, and there is a very nice straight profile line where the lighting unit can be nicely tucked away. I shall put the battery unit into the area where there is no windows so that it's nice and hidden out the way. I have done some pre-tutorial work, as I have covered the circuit board with some masking tape. Well, it's actually duct tape, but I thought I'd do this so that the metal from the battery doesn't short out any of these capacitors. I don't know how much room there will be available, as I've never done this kind of work before, but the stuff I'm going to use to secure the lighting unit into place will be this black tack. It's a bit similar to blue tack, but this has very strong adhesion. So I'll only be using 3 tiny amounts just to secure the lighting unit into place. And I will be doing some tests before fitting the battery. Well, actually, I'll just follow the instructions to the T and I shall install the battery now. However, just to keep things nice and simple, I will not be using the amber LEDs, as it's just too much faffing around, and I really want to keep the integrity of the body shell. So for this one, I'm only going to be installing the light bar only. Although I am sure there are other tutorials on YouTube that go full in depth, that will tell you how to drill out the holes for the LED lights. Although once I get confident with these lighting kits, as this is not the only unit that I plan to install coach lights into, I may well have a go at a later date at installing the warning lights. So, I do apologise for omitting that part out of this tutorial, as this is a very basic tutorial that I shall be doing. There is a tiny little bit of glue that holds the light bar to the sheet, so I'm just being very careful to pry this off. And this is your lighting bar. I'm just going to quickly touch my radiator just to ground myself, as I don't want to cause any static damage to the printed circuit board, although it should be fine, as there's not really much on the circuit boards apart from LEDs, but as I say, it's always better to be safe than sorry. Anyways, what I'm going to do now is I'm going to break the seal on this battery pack. It's kind of like a watch battery. There we go. A little bit stubborn, but we got it out in the end anyways. And if I just have a quick look at the instructions. Positive side, which is this side of the battery, should always be facing upwards, and you just pop it in like that. And it just simply clicks into place. And there we go. Just look at those beautiful lights. These carriage lighting units do have a motion activated sensor. So when it detects movement, these lights will come on automatically, and there is a 4-minute relay into the circuitry, and after the 4 minutes has elapsed, and if there's no further movement, the lights will automatically shut off. So this is a neat little feature, and also it does conserve battery usage. But anyways, now that we've got the battery all set up, I'm just going to place the lighting unit down there. And I'm just going to do some quick on-camera checks and fitment. As you can see, because of the metal, the lighting unit will be placed around there. Unfortunately, there is a few limitations, but as the circuit board of the Hornby DCC interface will block off one of the lights, or probably a couple of the lights, this part of the train will still be illuminated along with this front corridor, and I'm happy with that. If I just have a quick check, just making sure there's no pillars or anything that's going to obstruct the way. I'm now going to take the light strip off and place it on the manual just for now. And this is the black tack that I've just shown you earlier in the video. And I'm only going to use 3 tiny blobs of this. You really don't need much of this stuff to fix things like this into place, as this black tack has a much higher adhesion over the standard blue tack or the UHU white tack. Very good stuff. Often use this to secure decoders into place. Never had a problem with it. And I shall just place one there. Place one here. And here. And there we go. That should give us enough grip to secure the light unit into place. Just doing some fine adjustments whilst on temporary off camera, and that is where the lighting unit will be resident in my Class 153. I am just going to line this up so it's all nice and straight, as I do like things nice and tidy. And now the next thing to do, which is pure and simple, I'm just going to place the body shell loose on top of the carriage, as you can see straight away. It does look a lot better, doesn't it? And as you can see, there's no obstruction of the DCC plug, as this Railcar will be upgraded to DCC at a later date. So, next thing to do is to put this train back together. And it all clips together quite nicely, like so. And that's it. Very simple mod to do. And what I shall do next is do a running video of this 153 running on the test track. So, I'm just going to pause the video whilst I clear everything else up, and I shall follow with a test run. Right, I have had this Class 153 sitting on the test track for around about 2 minutes, but what I'm going to do before we go with the test run, just to test the motion sensor, as I do like to do thorough tests on my reviews, I'm just going to wait for a little moment for the timer to put the lights to sleep, and then I'm going to do a couple of loops or a couple of laps with this Class 153. And to be honest, the reason I chose the Class 153 is because it is the only DMU that I have in my fleet, apart from the first Great Western Class 150, as that one has lights, but this one until now didn't have any interior lighting. And to be honest, that was the only thing that was really missing from this otherwise very nice rail car from Hornby. But at the moment it's just a matter of waiting for the timer to shut the lights down, and then I'm going to wake up the lighting unit with some movement that should switch them back on. But as I did say in this video, there is a 4 minute relay in the timer before the lights go to sleep, to put it nicely. But this is not the only train tech review that I'm going to be doing, as I shall be doing a review of their other products in other videos. However, until I get a proper DCC train controller, most of the tests will be performed on DC mode only. Well, there you go. The 4 minutes has elapsed and the light unit, the timer, has actually put the lights to sleep, which is a very nice feature, as this eliminates the need for any switches. Now, I'm just going to make a fine adjustment to the camera, and I'm now going to put some power onto the track and wake up the lighting set. As you can see, less than a second, the light unit has now come to life. And I'm just going to do a couple of laps with this room light switched on. I'm just going to move some of the packaging out of the way, as I'm going to dip the lights in a moment to show off the lighting kit in darkness. Right, I'm just going to make a fine adjustment to the camera, just so I can get more of the track into the filming zone. I'm just going to go over to the other end of the room, and I'm just going to ditch the lights. I usually edit this part out of the video, but I'm not going to bother this time around. But just wait for it, and you will see that the illuminated lights inside the train for yourselves. I don't know if the camera is picking it up, but although the interior lights are, they're not overkill, but they are not too dull either. But anyways, I'm just going to go over to the other side of the room again and put the lights back on, and I'm going to finish this review with my final score and verdict. Just tweaking the camera to put it back in its final position. So, my verdict on this, definitely recommended if you're into night operations like I am and you wish to fit carriage lights. The price for these lighting sets, as they do include two warning lights for the doors, which I could have fitted into this unit if I drilled out the painted warning lights, but I might do that later. But the reason I haven't bothered with this one is because I wanted to keep as much of the integrity of the Class 153 DMU as much as possible. I'm going to give this lighting unit a perfect 10 out of 10. It's a very nice set from Train Tech, and this is amongst the very first products of Train Tech that I've had experience with, and I'm pleased to say it's a very positive experience, and I'd certainly recommend them. However, you might need to make some adjustments for these shorter carriages, like if you wish to fit this lighting unit into a Class 142 Pacer, and the instructions do cover this anyways. Likewise, that's all there is really to say about this video. I'm going to finish this off with a perfect 10 out of 10 for the lighting unit. Bear in mind, this is a review for the lighting unit itself and not the Hornby Class 153, as I did do a review of this DMU back in 2011, as we are now in 2015, but nonetheless, that's more or less my Class 153 project near enough finished. But anyways, thank you for watching. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to post them in the comment section below. And have a good week. Stay tuned for the next video to come soon, and bye for now.